Hi everyone, Dana Williams here, your soul mission mentor and artist of change. And today I want to talk about some bridge building. So as you can see, there's a bridge here and it is joining one part of this real estate over to the other part of real estate. And it's very similar to what we need to do with our younger, wounded, limiting beliefs and parts of ourselves that live in the past. Because basically, they didn't get to come full circle and get completed. And then there's a gap, there's a disconnect from the then to the now, and what happened then just keeps getting, spun. That story keeps getting spun, and then it gets projected into the future. Now, the subconscious, the number one job of the subconscious is to keep me safe. So if it has an incomplete story in my energy field from the past, it's going to keep showing it to me, sort of like an incomplete, undigested story, okay? Because it's incomplete. So it'll do a couple of different things. It'll get my attention with the incomplete story, and it'll show me what's undigestible. It'll also remind me over and over and over again, like an alarm, like a red alert. Don't let this happen again. So then to me, to my adult self in the now, it can often feel like an assault from the orphaned parts that are in the past. But I want you to change your thinking around that. I want you to kind of give yourself a reframe so that instead of avoiding those stories to stop the pain, we will very often numb ourselves down and distract what really needs to be healed. So we're kind of working against our own weather station, because it's basically like a barometer showing us the weather, okay? And sometimes it can get very stormy in our energy field. And usually that's because we are eclipsed by other people's energies, maybe from a story in the past, or maybe our own fall from grace where we made a huge mistake and we wish that we never would have done it that way. Either way, the idea is to pick up your messages and recognize that these story boxes are holding you back from having all of your energy in the now, okay? Because this, look at, if you were to see the different aged parts that live under these story boxes, you would really get an idea of how much of you is actually showing up in the course of the day. It might be a very small percentage. And then when you get triggered, guess what? This is who is answering, making decisions. Okay. So what we want to do is we want to build that bridge over to this younger part. And we want to, acknowledge the truth of the limiting belief, or acknowledge the truth of the emotions that did not get to be expressed. So sometimes they just get stuffed down and piggybacked to the point where it's really hard for us to have clarity about how to heal them or how to become complete. So we're building that bridge just by stating the truth of the story. And then what can happen is this younger part might get excited and the symptoms may even go up. But they also, when you stay with the story, the symptoms will typically start to release and become more neutralized. And then that part can come home to me and I can make clear decisions. So every time you get triggered, you have the opportunity for a do-over, unless you choose to take the bait and become the story. So try and keep this in mind for today and the rest of the week, and notice what those stories are. What are those feelings that are trapped in that non-local time zone, which could be the past, or it could be projected stories in the future, okay? So stay tuned for more to come. I did take the summer off, in case you've been wondering where I've been. But September is a new school year, and I'm back in action. So hopefully this was helpful. Feel free to email me if you want to have me do a training on something specific that you may be stuck with. All right, we'll see you next time.